My name is Nekme Obasoge. I'm here to discuss about one of the heroic ancient women in Benin Kingdom during the pre-colonial era, Imagwero. There's one girl secondary school in Benin called Imagwero College. It's located at Saple Road. We also have India College, Imota College. Schools were named after these prominent women in pre-colonial era of Benin Kingdom. We cannot discuss about the history of either war or the history of Idian Yesige, the first woman that fought a war in Benin Kingdom, without reflecting on the role Imagwero played in precipitating the Ida War. One thing must have mitigated to another that exacerbated the Ida War. Imagwero was a very pretty woman, beautiful to behold in the 16th century. And Oba Esige was the Oba of Benin at that time. Imagwero was not born into the family of a chief or a royal family. It was her beauty that took her to the house of Chief Olia. At that time, there was a tradition that stipulated that the first daughter of the Oba of Benin must marry either Iyasere of Benin or Chief Olia. However, this tradition was reformed during the reign of Oba Akinzuwa II, who ruled the Benin Kingdom during the 20th century. Oba Akinzuwa II was the grandfather of this current Oba of Benin, Oba Ewari Ogirigan II. This picture shows when Oba Akinzuwa II gave his first daughter to ordinary Itijin of Benin in the 20th century. Right now in Benin Kingdom, the first daughter of the Oba has the right to marry any man of her choice. She is no longer restricted to marry either Iyasere of Benin or Chief Olia. Going back to the history of Imagwero, she was married to Chief Olia in the 16th century, while the first daughter of Oba Esige, Princess Anie, was also married to Chief Olia. However, the chief was so much in love with Imagwero, even though Imagwero was a barren woman, she had no child of her own. Then she was like the pride of Chief Olia. Whenever they are having elders meeting in the palace, Chief Olia will brag and boast about how Imagwero is the most beautiful and faithful woman in the kingdom. And Oba Esige was not impressed with the frequent comment from Chief Olia. He felt insulted because his first daughter was also married to Chief Olia and the chief was not showing any interest of love to his daughter. And moreover, the Oba believes that there is no woman in the kingdom that was more precious and faithful than his own mother, Idian Yesige. It was the love he had for his mother that led him to reform the tradition of burying the mother of the crown prince along with the Oba. Prior to the reign of Oba Esige in the 16th century, any mother of the crown prince was buried along with the Oba. The Benin people believed that the mother of the crown prince was as powerful as the Oba himself, and they were not ready to serve two Obas because the Benin people regard the Oba as a deity, as a god. So if the mother of the crown prince is as powerful as the Oba, which means they are serving two gods. That is why they subjected the mother of the crown prince to death whenever her husband joined his ancestors. The beauty of Imagwero almost robbed the kingdom of its peace and unity during the reign of Oba Esige. The Oba, who felt so insulted by the comment of Chief Olia, did something unusual to address the issue. He decided to send one of his servants with some coral beads to Imagwero and demanded for her love. Unfortunately, Imagwero refused the request. That is when the Oba threatened to kill her parents. Imagwero was scared. She decided to take a break from the house of Chief Olia. She told the chief that she's homesick, that she wants to visit her parents. She told her parents what is going on in the kingdom, that the Oba threatened to kill them if she refused the love request. Given that the Benin people are so loyal to the Oba of Benin, the parents advised Imagwero to submit to the request of the Oba as soon as possible. The Oba had an affair with Imagwero. of which is a taboo for the Oba to have sexual relationship with the wife of Chief Olia. Maybe to humiliate or to prove to Chief Olia that you can never trust a woman, Oba Esige did the unthinkable in one of the elders' meetings. He decided to introduce one of his servants and told the Benin people that his servant had an affair with Imagwero, of which in reality it was the Oba himself who had an affair with Imagwero. Imagwero, who was subjected to a sex tool in the kingdom, felt so disgraced and humiliated by the action of the Oba, she decided to commit suicide. Before she died, she confessed to Chief Olia that she had an affair with the Oba. It was the threat of trying to kill her parents that led her to submit to the Oba. Chief Olia was worried and grieved about how the Oba betrayed him in the kingdom. He retaliated. That is when he sent some of his servants to the king of Ida and told them that the Benin kingdom is planning to wage war against them. And the same servant to the Oba of Benin and told the Oba that the Ida people are planning to invade the Benin kingdom and take possession of the Benin monarch. That is what later led to the Ida war. The history of Benin Ida war is a very unique one because it was the first time that a woman fought a war in Benin kingdom. Idiani Yesige, she fought the Ida war. And it was the first time of using guns to fight tribal war in West Africa. Through the help of the Portuguese, it was very easy for the Benin kingdom to conquer the Ida people. At that time, the Benin people were maintaining a strong relationship with the Portuguese.
The Benins benefited so much from that relationship they had with Portuguese. Aside bringing Christianity, aside the trading, thirdly, it was we benefited from the warfare, the Benin Ida War. That was the first time. It was 1515, all right, that Benin Ida War happened. Now the Benins can remember the exact date of that Benin Ida War because a letter was written by one Duarte Perez, who was a Portuguese merchant working for the King John at that time, that he wrote a letter to the King John that Benin's is highly a Christianized society because of the presence of the missionaries. However, they were currently fighting a war. So that war, that letter is quoted to be the oldest letter ever written in Nigeria. It was written October 20, 1516. All right. So it was that letter the Benins could remember because that letter stated that it was almost a year since that war has prevailed. So that means the war actually happened between 1515 and 1516. So in that war, the Benins were able to display in the first time in the history of what we now call Nigeria using of guns. All right. The Benins were the first people to use guns to fight war.
Through the help of the Portuguese.
Because at that time, there was a clause, the first clause that you must understand, that there was a law that the king of the Portuguese had put, or more of the Christian world in the Europeans that had at that time, that until you are a Christian nation, the Europeans should not give guns to anybody, any natives, any country that are not Christianized. So one would also say that maybe one that was one of the reasons Oba Esige decided to become a Christian so that he can have those machineries, those weaponry to fight and further expand his already vast empire. So that was why, because the Benins were the first Christians in this part of the world, so we were also the first people that were given that right to possess guns as weapons. At the time where javelins, spades, arrows were being used as weapons of warfare.
We are planning to produce a documentary based on Benin Ida War next year. Hopefully, by the grace of God, in the next 6 or 7 months, we might be able to produce it and publish it for public consumption. Okay? Before I leave, I would like to do a critical analysis of this book. I read the history of Imagwero from this book. And I disagreed with the conclusion of the author. I'm going to read it right now. According to him, he said, "The point is, women were and have remained important instruments in the development of socio-political culture in pre-colonial Benin. Behind every successful kingdom, there is a woman. The life of Imaguero and the Benin Ida War once again reaffirms the place and relevancy of women in pre-colonial Benin Empire. I don't think this conclusion is coherent with the experience of Imaguero, because I was expecting the author to elaborate on how she was being oppressed due to patriarchy arrangement of Benin Kingdom at that time. Because if you look at the experience of Imaguero, it was not a happy ending. She committed suicide due to the oppression imposed on her by the men. We have to call a spade. I disagree with this type of conclusion. Anyway, that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching.